One of the main tributaries in our study was, of course, the Nonquon River. We received reports from locals that there are a number of spawning locations up the Nonquon. Upon further investigation, however, we found that there exists only a small section of the river that's suitable for walleye. The suitable habitat that does exist is located upstream of Seagrave and is about 100 meters long. Walleye typically spawn on gravel or cobble substrates in relatively shallow waters that are well oxygenated. These habitats exist only in a small section of the Nonquon River. Our water quality sampling at the River Road Bridge indicates that dissolved oxygen concentrations are quite low in the summer, approaching in some cases 0 mg/L. Now the warm water fish community that uses the Nonquon River and Lake Scugog are pretty tolerant in terms of low dissolved oxygen. When levels get too low, fish will avoid the area and will not be able to thrive. It is important to note that we did not see those low levels of oxygen in the early spring spawning season, just in the summer. So why are these low levels happening? Well, we're not entirely sure. It could just be the natural conditions of the river itself, but it is relatively rare to have low dissolved oxygen concentrations in the surface waters of a flowing river. It could be due to the local land use in the area or in the watershed, or even due to the Nonquon River Water Pollution Control Plant, or other factors such as internal cycling of nutrients. But there was no obvious connection we could make in this initial study. These low dissolved oxygen levels are a major area of concern for us, and therefore we see an opportunity for future research projects.